Good day, one, and thanks for joining us here in the charts. You're tuned into the Market Beast Edition. Your fellow compadre speaking. And today we'll be exploring the SENS ticker symbol, Sensonics Holdings Incorporated. Just going to basically reiterate what we've already gone over. Take the time to revisit our previous video. Right now it's in a very large range. I'm going to pull up that for you wonderful folks here in 1 second. If you're just joining us, welcome in. We have a different energy on YouTube, not the most formal or the professional, but we do our best to maneuver through the markets. We'd love for you to join us here. Consider the subscribe button if we actually put out any useful information. Loyal subscribers, welcome back. The YouTube algorithm is picking up on the channel. Thank you for your engagement and your appropriate thumbs. Let's go ahead and dive into this chart to see what we have here, shall we? All right, so today's February the 23rd, 2021, and the current price of SENS is the ticker symbol, is $3.54. It's down approximately 13.2% for the day. Markets are currently open, obviously, if you haven't looked on the screen there. Here's the lines. Really simple. So these are our infamous lines. I haven't changed anything. These are the weekly candles. It's cranking on up, so if you, maybe you could see it a little bit better. I don't know, like 3 weeks or something, something weird. All right, so here's everything. The all-time high has been accomplished. I think we did say on a previous video that the markets are trying to go to the all-time highs. This green line represents $5.05. The all-time highs, it appears that it's getting rejected from that level. Is this an official rejection? Well, the market has used quite a bit of energy. Let's just do this. I want to let everyone know. Remember, when I'm looking at this stuff, I'm just looking at the story, okay? I don't have any fundamental data. I still don't know what the stocks is. Nor am I ever interested in any of these stocks. I don't have a relationship with them. Let me get this out of the way. Please execute your strategies. Know how much you're going to risk. Know where you're going to take profits. Know where you're going to take a stop loss if the market goes against you. I'm not being paid to say any of this. This is a frequent request that we're getting. I don't have an email in the description to contact me, so I'm not sure if this is a scam or not. I just have to get all of that out of the way for the critics, okay? So we're starting right here on this level, December the 7th over to present day. Let's measure how much time it's taken for the markets to move to that level. On over to the all-time high. So 71 days, that is a lot of energy. Somebody say, what are you talking about energy, dude? Stop talking weird. It's basically markets, like people don't look at markets as if they're, the markets are alive. They're sounds so weird. The markets are, they're humans' behavior, okay? Just look at it as buyers and sellers. So the buyers have had a very aggressive thrust to the upside ever since December the 7th. Let's see how much of a percentage gain has gone up. Ever since like 44 cents, it's gone up almost 1,146%. So the buyers have used a lot of energy. So right now, the sellers may step into this market. Let's go ahead and let you know where the range is. This descending channel is the only thing that we can go by right now. I guess we can pull up the lower time frames and try to find a previous level of resistance, which could be identified right here at this level. If you want to, if the markets are going to continue to go to the downside, if you notice, we already have a wick below that level. The wick is as low as $2.75. Maybe got some stop loss cut out there. Do I think the markets will continue to push to the downside? I'm not sure, guys. But this will be the range from a weekly's perspective. The $2.98 level all the way up to the all-time high at about $5.05. So please write these levels down. They're never strategic. I promise you, they're never strategic, guys. Don't trust me, okay? I'm not a trustworthy person. The only thing that I do on this channel is turn on a mic. I explain the story behind price action. That's all I ask for you guys, your patience. Have an open mind. Be kind. In the comment section, I work very hard on these stocks, doing this for free. I'm not asking anyone for any money, okay? This is all complimentary via Napoleon Macro, okay? So $2.98 up to $5.05 is the current range until otherwise, right? And if it breaks down below that level, it's going to be above this yellow line. This yellow line is most important for me. So I'd much rather tell you that it's within a much larger range because I feel that the markets may not be finished flushing out just yet. Maybe it is. I'm not sure. I don't care one way or the other. Please have a strategy if the market goes against you. If the market goes down like 50%, you have to know how are you going to stomach that? How are you going to position yourself in the market to protect yourself from downwards pressure, okay? You have to know all that stuff before you hit that buy button, okay? I know I say that a lot, guys. I have to say that every single video. I don't like to see people lose money. I'm not losing money in these markets. All right, so let's see. Did I say the range? Stop talking. See, right here, It varies because it's a descending line. It probably is going down in very small increments. So let's just say $2.18. I know on the last video that we posted on Sensonics, we said as long as the price is above $2.09, I think it was, the trajectory will continue higher. And I think we posted that video somewhere on this this red candle here, maybe even this green candle. It continued the trajectory to the upside. It's met the overhead target at $5.05. So when the price goes from a specific level and it actually reaches the target and then there's a retracement, it's kind of hard for me to understand what could take place next, because I'm only looking at the price action from range to range. And right now it's still stuck between this range that I said, $2.19 all the way up to $5.05. It didn't break through the all-time high. So what has to happen now? The market appears to be correcting down. Is it going to back test the previous level of resistance? Like I said, I don't know, guys. $2.09, that's the only level. If you really want to get like extreme, in an extreme case scenario, if the markets are going to continue to push to the downside, I'd look at $2.09. So let's just cut it out here. I'm going in circles. $2.09 is the extreme range. If it breaks down below $2.09, be open to that as well. Okay, just have a strategy. I know I said that 10 times. I'm going to say it again before we close it out. $2.09 all the way up to $5.05. If this isn't useful information, I'm not sure what else to say to you guys. I do appreciate your time, but we got to cut it out here. That's all I have for you wonderful folks. Hopefully you're doing well out there and you're practicing risk management in these markets. Really big moves in the markets today, I'll say that. So we'll close it out here. Thank you for your time. Leave an appropriate thumb just below the video there if you enjoyed the content, if you found any valuable information in this video. Thank you for that. Also, before you go, if you're new, we cover the alternative markets. I'm not sure if you're into Bitcoin and altcoins, but we cover that throughout the week. Subscribe, hit the bell. We'll send you that information when it is available. I think we covered everything. Yes, good, out we go. Take care of yourselves. Protect your portfolio. Execute your strategies. Your strategies, not my strategy, okay? We're going to talk very soon. Bye for now.